Hollywood, isn't it?
When I think of the golden age of Hollywood, I think of the 30s, 40s, and 50s.
Isn't this something that she would wear, right?
May West Roman.
We're pulling for American Horror Story Season 4.
I'm looking for lovely Heidi Klum.
Doris, I have this huge editorial, 40 pages.
40? 40?
Yeah. And it's all going to be film noir. I love those decades. The silhouette is just so striking and so beautiful.
Oh, you're doing the red carpet.
Yes.
Pretty sexy, right?
Yes, the right kind of sexy.
I think this is the biggest pull we've ever done.
Get in there.
This vintage clothing store is a window into fashion's Hall of Fame.
Oh my God. This dress is a weapon. Are you kidding me? Amazing.
When I think of the golden age of Hollywood, I actually think of the 30s, 40s, and 50s because it's a time when fashion and film were so critical.
This makes me happy.
That's Hollywood siren vamp. The golden age of films that were so much about wardrobe.
So the very strong shoulders and the very severe cuts were descriptive of a very empowered woman.
Every silhouette is different, and it's a time when fashion actually revered the female form.
I really first learned about fashion through the golden age of film.
Gail.
Hi.
When it comes to Hollywood royalty, Gail Paul is a fashion stylist at the top of her game. She has styled many celebrities from Cameron Diaz, Gwyneth Paltrow. One of her special clients is Adele.
Doris, I have this huge editorial. It's for S Magazine. It's like a big format art magazine that comes out twice a year. They want 40 pages.
A 40-page editorial?
Yeah. 40 pages. We've got to do 40 pages. And it's all going to be film noir. And the photographers love doing that kind of cinematic picture. And I just thought of you.
Gail wanted to know if she could do a huge pull just from us. And we were thrilled because it's a lot of press for us.
This would be just such wonderful clothes to put in that. Amazing, like, tweeds, pencil skirts. Like a little Hitchcock with a hat and veils. And then maybe we could do some kind of underwear, some bustiers.
Torpedo bullet?
A little bit, torpedo bullet, yeah.
Wonderful, and all women, yes?
And all women.
Uh-huh.
This is exactly what I'm talking about, you know? With like just a bra underneath. Be some like little hats, and maybe I could add some, you know, pins, some brooches. So excited you said yes.
Oh, absolutely. For you, anything.
It's a lot of pages to fill.
This reminds me of the 20s coat.
Beautiful.
Yeah? And then I know this is a completely different direction.
Yeah, but it's got that film noir feel.
Film noir is a genre of film that has to do with dark and sinister. It was very strong in the 40s and 50s, think a lot of the Hitchcock films. So when I think of film noir, I think of very strong female silhouettes, which I love. Do you mind just pulling a few things to kind of get our eye and edited in the right direction?
Yes, let's do it.
Great.
Right?
Yeah, because it's fitted.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I can totally see that in a Hitchcock film.
That's pretty, you know, with a pencil skirt.
Yeah, okay.
My heels.
Kind of a sexy secretary.
Yes. I particularly like that one.
Okay.
They generally pull more than what I need, and so my job is to take it out and keep it condensed.
Okay, I think I get a sense of where you're going with this.
Yeah, okay.
So, do you want to give us a few hours to...
Yeah.
...to do our whirling dervish routine?
Bye, Gail.
Bye, Sarah.
See you shortly.
Woo! As I begin to tackle the pull for Gail, Sarah was well prepared for a visit from a very popular television star.
So we got a call from Kirsten Vagnus. She is on Criminal Minds. She wants to take a look at some vintage looks for some possible red carpet events, and that's very exciting.
I know. And this is it.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Look at this.
You're in for a treat.
I've been here a few times. I loved it. That's why I wanted Kirsten to come.
We're amazing.
Theater pals. We're in the same theater company.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. So we knew you were coming, so we went ahead and we pre-pulled a rack of stuff that maybe we wanted you to be in or that you might like.
Being a theater nerd, you always have like a thing you gotta go to for that.
Oh, and then television. I also happen to have that fancy day job.
All of it might be wrong, all of it might be right, but if you go through it and we start to see what you like, then we can pull more fruitfully.
I like things to look vintage but modern at the same time. Like I like a little fantasy and a little whimsy, but not too much. I don't like to go over.
It comes from her, so whenever she puts on, it's sort of like that's Kirsten's dress.
Can I just take off all my clothes and get in here and roll around?
No, someone did that yesterday. It wasn't a lot of fun.
Yes. Yes.
Which, no.
Maybe.
You can put a picnic basket in my hand. Should I try them all on?
I sort of like
it. This jacket is fantastic. Right? And I want to do a music video right now in it. You know why I'm saying no to these? Do you know who should wear these? There's a girl on this TV show called Criminal Minds, and she plays the computer genius.
Oh,
she types and stuff. This looks like this would be perfect
that
on her.
Call her. This is enough.
Okay. Yeah.
This is good for first time.
Vintage clothing is for everyday wear, for every occasion. If you have to wear clothing, there's an application for vintage. You do have to wear clothing, don't you?
I go in there right now.
But then
wish me luck.
But I'm kind
of curious. What if some of the garments are haunted?
If you get trapped, if you get scared, if you get anything at all, I'm here for you. Thank you.
When I think of film noir, I think of women in dramatic hats. So my first place to pull from for Gayle is my hat room.
That's a good one. Yeah, that's good.
Hats are such an important part of creating that film noir effect. I like to try these things on because sometimes these heads are so small. But I think I'm going to include it because it's so dramatic. And I think with the veil, it will be a good alternative for her. I've got a good selection of potential hats.
Great.
There we go.
But that's 5 editorial pages down and only 35 to go.
So I asked Jill to help me look for some classic 40s suits and sexy dresses.
I really love, especially the 1940s, just the architectural structured long gowns I think are really incredible, really sexy, and they make a really strong image.
So, I think I found some things.
You did. I love this tweed.
Isn't it great? I think it's really cool. I was surprised that it's Guernsey. I'm used to seeing, you know, very vibrant 60s.
And very sexy.
And then I pulled this guy. Not sure. I'm not sure if I was missing the mark on this one. I thought it might be a cool piece, but maybe too busy?
You know what? Let Gayle decide on that.
Okay. Then again, this is, I know it's evening, but
yeah, that's such
really
a beautiful
cool
piece.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Since it's a 40-page spread, I'd love to have at least 100 pieces for her to look at.
We can make that happen.
Yeah.
When we think of the 30s, 40s, and 50s, at least as far as Hollywood goes, we think of the great designers from Adrian,
who created the large shoulder-padded femme fatale look of Joan Crawford, and Travis Banton, the man behind Marlene Dietrich's famous feathers.
You can look at the history of film and see how their designs totally impacted what was produced commercially.
Is this amazing?
Is that a Bob
Mackie?
I love
this. It's a Bob Mackie.
That right there is a piece of Hollywood royalty.
I'm going to faint if that fits her.
I got you. You never know if it's you've picked the right things or not until the moment happens. So we have our fingers crossed. I think we're covered, but you never know.
Didn't fit me. But
what's happening here?
I feel like if I channel it. Now, the good thing is that my panties are the same color red. We're just pretending that this is all part of the fashion. Where's my mark?
And I kind of like it with the tush sticking out. I think it's fun.
It's kind of warm up here.
Yeah. It's just gorgeous.
Isn't this something that she would wear, right?
Kristen's ready again.
Okay, this is sort of like the millionaire's widow.
You're having a noir moment.
It's sexy, sexy, sexy. The hat that you have in your hand, before Halston was a designer, he was a milliner. So that's a hat, that's one of the hats that he did before he became a designer.
Oh my God.
So you had some nice history on your head.
I know, it's like touching the Rosetta Stone.
It was made of... Can you speak French now?
Un peu. Je reprends le français maintenant, mais...
It works!
Just put your lips together and blow.
I knew it. I knew it the second I saw it. I knew it in my heart.
I enjoy this.
I'm not the only one seeing what I'm seeing. That's just beyond adorable. It's just beyond,
I love this. I want to wear this to a thing. And it would be so perfect because this is exactly how short I want things to be. This...
With the bloomers.
Oh, that's fantastic. I love you. Thank you guys so much for having me.
It's the hug of fashion.
Vintage is more than just clothing. It's about what you're wearing, why you're wearing it, how you're wearing it, when you're wearing it. Because fashion is always going to be representational. Fashion is always going to be about communication.
Thank you. This is where the time is from.
You know, when we walked in, we didn't know what adventures this place held.
I know.
And now we do.
That was awesome. Kirsten ended up buying a red leather jacket, a little black dress, a little mermaid dress. She didn't buy the Bob Mackie, but that was pretty much just for our own pleasure. The way we wore.
Hey, Gail, do you mind if I put you on speaker for a quickie?
We've got a healthy rack of things pulled for you. Are you heading in?
I want to get something today.
You let me know what looks good for you.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
Gail called and said she wasn't going to pick up the pull until tomorrow. So we have some more time to hone the pull. But the reality is there is no guarantee any of it will make the cut. This store is the epicenter of fashion as we know it. We have a wonderful array of people coming into our store, from our friendly neighbors.
How are you doing?
To high-profile celebrities. The best part is, being in Los Angeles, we get great stylists coming in. Not to forget mentioning costume designers as well, because Hollywood is Hollywood.
The way we wore.
I say every day is Christmas. We never know who's going to walk in the door, and we never know what's going to walk in the door.
Hi.
Hey, Mariam.
How are you?
Good. Nice to see you. Oh.
Mariam Malekpour is one of the preeminent stylists today. She's pulled for Angelina Jolie, Scarlett Johansson. She's worked with Keith Richards. She's been doing her job for so long and been doing it so well that she only does really top-tier projects and clients now.
Looking for some great belts.
Oh, okay.
For my lovely Heidi Klum. We're doing a fitting in New York, so... Uh-huh.
So yeah. Just accessories.
Yeah, today, accessories.
I'm embarrassed to say I don't know where the belts are.
We put all the really new ones upstairs.
Oh, okay.
She knows. I actually know where they are.
You know better than I do.
I do.
That's very funny.
Let's go look at belts.
Okay.
Yeah?
Great. I really try to discourage people from cookie cutter vintage wear. And so it's great when people put their own spin on things by either accessorizing or having something tailored. And accessories can play just as big a role in putting your personal stamp on something as the clothes you wear. It's got the sliding.
This is what's genius.
Yep.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Looks great.
Try this. This is beautiful.
Yeah, the color's great.
Oh,
yeah.
I love that.
Great. And guess who it is?
Judith Lieber.
I love you, Judith Lieber.
I'll do an edit later. It's always fun. Let's just keep looking.
Sure.
A lot of times, you know, I'm on a project and we don't have the budget to really invest on an expensive dress. So, you know, a great belt, like, changes the look.
I think that one's YSL, actually. Yes.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
This is all such inspiration. I mean, look at this piece. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah.
I mean...
That's Armani.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. It's OB. OB style.
Yeah. I'm always looking for something different. All about femme fatale, you know, like sexy, gorgeous woman. I think using vintage is inspiring, and you know, you see where new designers are going, and then you just come and find the authentic pieces, which is kind of an amazing find.
Mariam was just targeting belts on this visit, but then she couldn't resist the clothes.
Who can miss a Gianni Versace leather miniskirt? Sorry.
Vintage clothing covers so many different styles and decades. It's something that's constantly being referred to with current fashion designers, so it's always on point.
Now I've seen this amazing Terry Mugler white suit, and I'm thinking Heidi would look amazing in it, so I think I might have to pull it.
Marion Malicourt has that effortless chic thing going on, and every pull she does just makes perfect capsule sense because she's so tuned in to the people she works with.
This is one of those amazing days when we have one of fashion's biggest stylists, Marion Malicourt, upstairs, and then suddenly, who walks in but award-winning costume designer Lou Eirich with her design partner Bob Sparkman.
We're pulling from American Horror Story Season 4 called...
Freak Show.
Freak Show.
We're pulling for Jessica today.
Jessica Lange's character. So we want great quality vintage from the 40s, 50s.
Circusy stuff.
Yeah. Carnival theme. That's all we can tell you.
It's top secret.
In my store, I only carry vintage clothing that's in excellent condition and can be worn today. Because Lou and Bob's characters are part of a carnival in the early 50s, they need to find costumes that are more theatrical and look rather worn and tattered. So it's a challenging pull, but I found some things in my back stock that could work well for them. Lou, I've got a few things that I thought you might want to, just to kick, also give me an idea of where your head is at. And then,
so great. The bummer is we have to, like, age everything down and make it look like they've been wearing it for 30 years, so I would hate to destroy this.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's not in perfect condition. Yeah. You know, it's a piece that I bought from someone who came from Vegas.
Yeah.
That's really beautiful.
And our color palette's all pastels.
It's all pastels, so that's great.
How perfect. The palette is a little stronger than you want.
So we can dust that down. Yeah, that part I'm not worried about.
I bought a number of these theatrical pieces at auction over 20 years ago when I rented costumes to the film and television industry. And I'm glad that I held on to them all of these years because I believe any good vintage piece will eventually find its rightful home. Now, it's older, 20s, but
we're backdating.
Some of it needs to be look like they've had it for a long time.
Backdating is a term that's used a lot by costume designers. You know, when you pull for a film or a TV show, you have to keep in mind the class of the people, and I was specifically told that these people have seen better times. So if it's 1952, they wouldn't be wearing clothing from the 50s, they'd be wearing things from the 40s and older. It's important, in order to make a film look real, to keep that in mind.
With the skirt.
Yeah.
This is a yes. And the size looks great as well.
Yeah, it's a wearable. And look at the trapunto on the bottom. I mean, I've never had a suit like this before.
Yeah, this is beautiful.
Are you okay time-wise? We're past 10 of.
Well, I'll have Bob measure these waists real quick.
Bob? Lou and Bob are considering a couple of pieces for Jessica Lange's character, but they had to run off to a fitting. In the meantime, I want to dig through my storage for any more vintage pieces I might have that scream 1950s Freak Show Carnival. Meanwhile, Mariam has found some pretty great pieces for Heidi.
These are the yeses?
Those are the yeses. Oh, Heidi's going to look gorgeous in that. Did we check the sizes in this?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a nice tight pull.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah? Forever belts. We love the belts. They change. An old dress into something new.
Belts can change your life.
Yeah, you're all packed.
Do you want to help out to your car?
Why not?
All right.
I always like to have a chaperone.
Exactly.
Oh, bring her back.
Bye, guys. I'll be back
Thank
later.
Thank you. Aww.
Can I just take her with me?
Well, that was pretty good. A potential score for American Horror Story and a few pieces for Heidi Klum. I'm just reeling from the excitement. Yeah, the store looks like a bomb hit it. So, I'm tired. Can I go home now?
Sure, it's noon.
Yeah, why not?
Doris outruns all of us. She always says that she doesn't work that hard. She outruns, outworks, and outlasts the kids that we have working with us who are in their 20s. She's like a machine.
But I still have one more poll to go. Stylist Gail Paul is coming back for the biggest editorial spread we've ever had. 40 pages for a photography magazine. The dose of reality is that if you're not willing to really do the heavy work, then you're not cut out for the business. So I'm going to go and get the hats that I pulled yesterday, and you guys hit the floor if you wouldn't mind.
I'll cover the Northern Territory.
Okay. Okay, so Gail's coming in a little while, and we need to get the rest of her pull together. Gail came into the store saying that she was doing this huge photo shoot for a magazine that had the theme of film noir. So we're looking for, like, lingerie, pencil skirts, things that are body-hugging, but also think of the great classic film noir.
This is right up your alley.
So I'm going to go in the back, okay?
I'm going this way.
Okay.
Always sounds so sexy to me. I mean, I know it's more about the drama and the intensity and all that, but film noir fashion was very seductive and very vixenish and very over the top. So I always think of that in terms of what film noir fashion is.
Since it's a 40-page spread, I'd love to have at least 100 pieces for her.
Cool. This one? Purple noir? It's actually really beautiful.
This is really hot. Look at this, Tina. Isn't that incredible? One of my goals was to make the way we wore the best vintage clothing store in the world. I could say on the planet, in the universe. And it's because I just don't want to compromise on quality. To be able to put together over 100 pieces in just 24 hours is a testament to my many years of treasure hunting all over the country.
I hope nobody else comes in with a big noir shoot.
Sarah, look what I found.
Whoa. Is that one from the 30s?
Yeah, 30s or 40s. Yeah.
Wow.
Isn't that great?
Did she say anything about accessories?
Well,
those
hats.
Would be awesome. The Chanel gloves.
Oh, that's actually a great idea.
These are very noirish.
Okay, that's about 100 pieces right there. Hopefully, we have some winners.
Hi.
Hi, Gail.
Hi,
hey, Jane.
Good.
Wow.
A little tired from pulling.
Looks great.
Gosh, what is in here? This is so great.
This is how the women did it in the 50s.
Mm-hmm.
Look, this is very sort of Hitchcockish, isn't it?
And yeah, we didn't know if you were doing all black and white or color as well.
It's going to be very subtle tones. But,
okay.
But I love the, what do you call that, rara. That's great.
Yeah.
Look at the detail on that.
Madonna noir.
Madonna noir. Keep it. Literally, it's the largest pull we've ever done in the store. And if she used, you know, even a handful of things for that shoot, it's huge because of the kind of publicity that we're going to be getting from it.
There's still no guarantee, but with a shoot of this magnitude, I made a special exception to loan Gail the merchandise.
Yeah, you can't go wrong. That's a very classic Hollywood-style slip.
Lovely.
Yep.
So I'll take those. This is so pretty.
Oh, yeah. I would say late 1950s, very early 1960s. I'm not very familiar with the maker, but it looks like it was custom made for someone.
I'm always looking for things that have beautiful construction, and I would say that that would have to fall into the couture category.
Meaning garments that were handmade and finished and designed for a particular person.
You know, fashion is art on many levels. This is cool.
That's fab.
Oh.
Good silhouette.
This is exactly what I came here for, because I knew that she'd have a big prospects.
So we're ready to roll out.
Oh, I need a hat box.
Oh, yeah. Let me get you a hat box.
Actually, don't worry. You know what? You know what? Can I wear it?
A real statement.
Why not, honey?
Great. We've got everything.
Holy moly.
Thank you.
We've never done anything this big. You've got a huge amount of stuff.
How much did I get?
close to 50 grand.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
I'll hold the door. Just wait there.
You're going to have cars slamming on their brakes.
I know. Did you rent a truck for this?
Gail is such a pro. The level of respect we have for each other is really fantastic. I will be stunned. Nothing makes it into the editorial. The Golden Age was so much about wardrobe. I really enjoy the fashion of that era. The fact that you just got to play all day long with outfits just seemed like a fantasy to me. So when Shelley invited me to go see original pieces from a true Golden Age diva, I was ecstatic. Ema Sumac was a childhood icon of mine.
Okay. So you ready to go?
We're going to Damon Devine's apartment, and he was Ema Sumac's friend and caretaker. What? I think he did her hair and makeup as well, too.
Are you excited?
So excited. I can't wait.
It's hard to even believe that she was real. She's a really out-of-this-world singer. Amazing octave range, singing songs that were just a little off-kilter. She looked amazing. She sounded amazing. Her lifestyle seemed amazing.
Ema Sumac was always a source of great inspiration because not only was she what I saw as epitome of glamour and beauty, she was also strong. She was the ultimate diva. She owned the stage. She owned life. She was larger than life. And I love that.
Shelley found out about Damon Devine's rare collection through an Ema Sumac fan site.
I believe he has all her, like, gold stuff, like the Incan stuff she's known for. It's all the iconic stuff.
Well, let's go!
Yes, let's! Oh, you know what? I think he might have some of her actual costumes, too.
The chance to see and touch Ema's original pieces in person will be like stepping back in time and touching vintage gold.
All of our price tags are hanging on the outside. I have so much fun when I find the perfect marriage of what I've invested in when it goes on the proper body and the proper personality. I mean, it's just, it's magic.
Hi, how are you?
I'm Doris.
Doris? I'm Rye. I called a little bit earlier.
Oh, you're doing the red carpet.
Yes.
Okay, good.
My first
red
carpet.
How exciting! That's wonderful.
Thank you.
The event that Rye was going to was a tribute to Jane Fonda. And she wanted to wear a vintage dress that screams Hollywood glamour. Tell me a little bit about what you're looking for, because you've got a model's figure, so you can pretty much wear anything.
Well, I do like that svelte look, as if something's going to lay on me as if it was painted.
Not fussy. Okay. Let's start over here. So much of the vintage clothing experience is visceral. You touch it, you feel it, you look at it. So while Rye and I were feeling our way to the perfect red carpet dress, Sarah and Shelley were off to meet Damon Devine, former caretaker to the great Ema Sumac. He inherited part of her rare collection after she passed away in 2008.
Hello.
Hi. Come in.
Oh, thank you. Very nice to meet you.
Oh my god.
This is crazy.
So these are the famous Inca jewels.
Wow.
These look pretty amazing.
They are. And you can see the backs here.
Holy cow.
Are very, very
oh, that's so crazy.
This is a very, very, very famous sun piece. She wore it, I think, through her entire career. I never dreamed I would have that.
Damon sold a number of her pieces to fans over the years, but he held on to a special few that he just couldn't part with.
I mean, it's unimaginable.
I never dreamed I'd be seeing it. It's amazing. Seeing somebody look so, like, exotic and beautiful and not, you know, mainstream glamour, like, you know, the blonde Hollywood starlet.
Right.
And seeing her is just, like, life-changing.
Yeah. The jewelry was amazing, but an even better surprise waited for us in the next room.
So here's this.
Oh my god.
I'm dying.
Just hanging out.
That's very, very Ema. And then here she is wearing it.
Wow.
God, it's like it was made yesterday.
I didn't think it was even possible to see the stuff. Aside from it just being just glamour point blank, it's just
truly inspiring to see that she was really inspired by her indigenous roots. And to totally embrace her culture and, you know, where she came from is just a really powerful thing. And I'm all about that.
Back at the store, Ryan and I were making some serious headway on the quest for her first red carpet dress.
I see this as like Hollywood glamour. It's a British design duo, Belleville Sassoon and Lorcan Maloney. I think they did some of Princess Di's clothes.
And I know you said no black.
I was looking for color.
But I have this one dress, and it's Roberta Cavalli, who is a lover of women's bodies. And he knows how to drape and construct clothing to really show it.
Beautiful. It's stunning.
Yeah, it's and beautiful so silk. Yeah.
And I want to tell you that there's this beautiful dress on the mannequin around the corner that I was looking at.
Oh, great. Okay, I'll take that one off when you're in the dressing room.
Yes.
Holler if you need me.
Okay, I'll definitely need you.
Oh, boy.
Doris?
Yeah.
It's definitely for a young lady that's very well endowed, which
yeah, it's too big on you. Yeah. Wow.
But the color.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
And it's very, like,
it's so
very red carpet.
Very red carpet, very old Hollywood.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't feel like the 80s.
Wow.
It feels like something different, like a Veronica Lake.
Yeah. Mm. Beautiful. Very Gilda.
Yeah. Rita Hayworth.
Yeah. Okay, well, that was a good shot, but it definitely doesn't fit right.
Yeah.
I just placed this on the chair. Do you want to try that?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Now, I've never seen this dress on anyone, so this is going to be a treat for me. What a reaction.
Really Hollywood. Isn't it?
Wow.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's like a princess dress, and I love it. And it's so colorful and so, like, Natalie Wood, right?
Totally.
And Audrey Hepburn, right?
When I bought it, I was told that it was a copy of Christian Dior from the 50s.
It's not just cutting material. It's really like sculpting and look at the bows.
It's beautiful. It's so wonderful
Thank
for
you.
Me to actually see it on.
I'm the first person to try it on. The detail on that is incredible.
I'm just in awe of the draping.
And definitely with the hair up, right?
Oh, yeah. I think definitely have your hair up.
And some
a nice piece
jewelry.
Of jewelry. Don't you feel gorgeous in that?
Yes, like the bell of the hawk. I love it.
No one's going to pay attention to the honoree.
No, we must.
It's like upstaging the bride, right?
I don't want to try anything else on, but I want to.
Well, listen, if this is it, it's great. Hey, let's see if we can top that.
Okay, that would be fun.
Yeah.
A challenge.
So this is the cape.
A holy relic, shall we? Amazing.
So she wore it like that. You can see here.
Totally.
The fringe. And underneath was gold, as you see there.
All the lame.
And then this.
Oh, I recognize that.
This is her thing from the David Letterman
show. Yeah, I totally remember.
Oh, wow.
And not only David Letterman, but when she had the huge, huge comeback in the 80s, this is what she wore in the New York ballroom.
Wow, that's so great.
Every night. So this is the most famous Ema Sumac piece. When I saw this in her things, I couldn't believe I was even seeing it.
Awesome.
And this is her in it many, many, many times.
Oh, my God.
That's it. That's her in her in her home, actually.
I feel very inspired by the glamour of probably, like, the 1950s, early 60s, just because I grew up seeing, like, these super glamorous pictures of my grandmother and my mom. That makes me very sentimental, seeing those treasures of that time. This is a total life changer. Thank you so much.
Oh, good.
Thank you so much.
12-year-old self, like, one day.
Well, for me, that's the whole idea, so I'm really happy
yeah.
about that.
The visit to Damon Devine's house was pretty fabulous. He was so enamored of her and respectful of her memory that it was nice to see that it was in his hands. And he was able to tell Shelley, who was just completely blown over, some great stories. So it was a really big gift.
this reminds you of in a very strange way? It reminds you of La Dolce Vita. Do you remember her in the black dress?
You gotta see what this looks like.
Holy mackerel!
It almost has a burlesque quality to it.
Performance.
Look at how it hugs your body.
Wow.
Sexy, right?
Yeah, it's the right kind of sexy.
Something that comes up a lot with customers coming looking for dresses is what I call hanger appeal. There are a lot of dresses that just don't have it. I have to say, no, just wait, give them a chance, put them on a human body, and they really come to life. On hanger, just is a simple black dress, but on her body, amazing.
Well, what I love about this is the fact that it's made with these strips of this wonderfully light silk, and I think it's stitched onto a silk tulle. So it has this ethereal quality to it. But I'm going to say you will be the center of attention.
Well, this is interesting because I feel more like a vixen. I feel more like a femme fatale. Whereas the other one, I definitely felt more innocent, more Audrey Hepburn. And I came in wanting to feel glamorous and not having a cookie-cutter outfit. And I didn't want to wear anything modern. I wanted to go back in time. I wanted to honor, just that beautiful golden era of Hollywood. And so, so now, take them both.
Honestly, they're so totally different.
Yeah. I don't know because they're both so beautiful and so different. So, to be continued. Should I flip a coin?
I never insert my personal opinion on things unless someone asks me.
Doris?
I knew that she only needed one dress, and as much as the Cavalli looked incredible on her, I just felt that the taffeta floral dress was a much better choice.
Okay, thank you so much, everybody. Have a great weekend.
Rye couldn't decide. But with only 2 days before the event, she has a ticking clock. So hopefully, one of her dresses will make it to the red carpet.
Perfect. It's so perfect.
I love hearing
that. And we'll just put more blood on it.
Oh. Costume designer Bob Sparkman's back. He's picking up some vintage hats for the TV series American Horror Story.
It's dramatical.
Turns out he's interested in some of the old costumes I found for his carnival-themed episode as well.
Freak show. It's a traveling freak show that's in Florida. We're shooting in New Orleans. We'll be there for 7 months.
You know, there's no such thing as instant gratification when designers pull for a film or TV show because of the nature of their production schedules.
Bye, y'all.
But I've learned patience, and I'm hoping some of our pieces will eventually make it to the screen.
Doris!
Oh. Hi.
Oh. But I wanted to surprise you and show you what you did. All your styling.
Oh, my goodness. Rye couldn't decide on two very different vintage dresses for her first big Hollywood event. Time to find out which one made it to the red carpet.
It was a really beautiful night because it was all these amazing people, like silver and golden age of Hollywood. So it was so apropos for it to be a period piece dress. There were so many women in modern dresses and they didn't even stand a chance.
How wonderful.
It was really wonderful.
Wow. Great choice.
Everyone stopped me all the time. I just said, oh, we just have to tell you, your dress is amazing. And I said, oh, it's a 1950s inspired Christian Dior from the Baby War.
I mean, can we talk about gorgeous? The dress looked incredible on her. Hair and makeup was amazing. She was probably the best dressed woman there.
You're
an angel.
I don't want to leave, but I have a date.
Oh, good. It's date night.
It's date night, but I'm not cooking.
Great. Well, enjoy.
Okay.
Give my love
Thank
to
Thank you so
Benny.
Much.
Okay.
I shall. Bye, okay. Everybody.
Bye, Rye.
Bye.
Thank you. Wow. It's so much fun to actually see pieces that make it onto the red carpet. I don't know. I feel a certain sense of pride, you know, that my selections and my eye was strong enough and good enough to give a person the confidence to wear it on the red carpet. Hey!
Hello!
Who
postman.
Mail
came.
Delivery.
Great. What do we have?
I go.
I wonder what this is. You know what this is? Very cool. It's the magazine that Gail worked on.
Oh, awesome.
Jeez, talk about delayed gratification.
Open it up.
I will be stunned. Nothing makes it into the editorial. 40-something page spread, yeah. That was the largest pull we ever did.
No, doing the film noir shoot, it was a task. The biggest pull we've ever done. I think we had 2 full racks by the end of it. But it was great. It was a lot of fun.
Wow. So let's see. American Stories shoot. Wow.
What do we pull for again? We're looking for film noir, right?
Yeah. Here we go.
That's cool.
That's not us.
Cool.
That's not us.
Dress the way we wore. Dress.
Oh, that looks beautiful. That's a great shot.
Yeah.
Blouse the way we wore. Great, we made in some.
Did, this is good.
On page credit. Yeah. Slip the way we wore. That's huge.
That looks great.
Wow.
It's really great.
Hat and brooches. It doesn't say suit.
Okay.
It kind of looks like your Dior.
Yeah, it looks like the Dior, doesn't it?
Oh, it is ours.
Oh, it's the Gernreich.
It's the Rudy Gernreich.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
Wow.
Wow.
I never thought of Rudy Gernreich as noirish, but...
What a beautiful shoot.
Corset.
Yep, that's ours. How great. We get on-page credit on every single shot that we have things in. It's great. Stylist Gail Paul.
Woo-woo! That's great.
We pulled so much stuff for Gail, and I'm just so happy that we made it on so many pages.
It's a beautiful shoot.
Yeah.
It's a great, gorgeous shoot. You never know how it's going to turn out, but we were really happy with the images, and the layout was beautiful. Score the way we wore.
Maybe we should do our own noir shoot.
In my dream world, I get to wear a veiled, beautiful hat every single day and go around looking sultry, stepping out of a convertible, smoking a cigarette, holding a cigarette, and looking awesome.
Is Ron in?
Okay, Joe, wait, that light is crazy.
High up.
Okay. Let me do it again. Sorry, it's funny. Okay, everyone just relax for a second.
Lindsay, what about the push-ups? Nice.
That was great. Nailed it.